As you're all aware, our country is today observing the National Handlooms Day, a day marked for celebrating and honoring handloom weavers in India who have been through generations promoting and preserving India's handmade and hand-woven products. Celebrating this day, we have with us Ms. Shubha Sharma. She is a Commissioner cum Secretary, Handloom, Textile and Handicraft Department of Government of Odisha. And obviously, she's a prolific author as well, and I've known her for a while. Ma'am, it would be great if you could tell us about the ground realities for weaver community in Odisha. What are the challenges, and how do you visualize e-commerce platforms such as ours in resolving some of these challenges? Because we have been working for some time now.
At the outset, let me say I'm extremely privileged and honored to be here today with the spotlight on the weavers of Odisha and their highly skilled weaving tradition. Most of them feel that society has not given them the recognition and appreciation that they deserve. These people are literally living repositories and living records of our ancient heritage and culture. And yet we have failed them as a society in many ways by not giving them that appreciation. Having said all this, I am extremely optimistic because I do find that some of the youth, especially from communities such as the Meher community, who have practiced weaving for several centuries, are coming back to weaving and bringing in freshness of ideas. They are bringing in new designs, new colors. They are innovating in marketing practices. They are extremely friendly with e-commerce platforms, and they are working and selling their products on platforms such as Flipkart. We signed this MOU in 2020. And you have supported the weavers of Odisha by providing them a platform. And we look forward to deepening this partnership in the coming years. In fact, I am curious to know that it's been almost 2 years of inception of your program, Flipkart Samar. How is it doing, and where do you see it going from here?
No, thank you for this introduction and highlighting the challenges with weaver community and Indian national heritage handicrafts and all faced, and I think those are all very real challenges. But I think the opportunity it presents for future in terms of making sure that the underserved communities can leverage technology to have a better access, I think is huge. But I think only access probably won't work, as you rightly highlighted. We also need to make sure that our communities, the artisans and weavers, are also able to produce what market is demanding. So I think those consumer insights, if we can bring those consumer insights back to these communities to show what is needed, what is consumer demanding. And I think that could also be a good fusion in some sense, that, you know, you'll bring insights back to them, they produce those things, and I think there's a market present for them. So I think, as I see, I mean, obviously we have millions and millions of people who need to still get into the ecosystem. But I think where it shows the intent and where it shows the possibilities are humongous. And you know, we are excited when we partner, governments like yours and officials like yours who are so passionate to drive this. I have no doubt that, you know, learning from them, you using those feedbacks, we will not just bring more artisans and weavers into the platform, but make sure that they see measurable difference in their income. Many of those products from Odisha are on the marketplace. Consumers are loving it. Obviously, there is an opportunity to do a lot more on that front. My question to you would be, you know, what else, you know, we can do and in terms of really highlighting the unique art that Odisha sort of brings.
One of the very important aspects, I think, is to create awareness amongst consumers. You know, a lot of people, when they talk about Odisha fabric, they think it's only Sambalpuri sari. And I in fact did the same thing a few years back. But I'll share a little secret with you. Actually, very few saris are actually woven in Sambalpur. Though it is a GI that we have, because Sambalpur was an undivided district. But the real handloom heartbeat of Odisha is in so many places. We have cotton ikat in Bargarh, we have silk ikat in Bomtai in Sonpur, we have the famous Nua Patna Khandua, we have Kotpar natural dyed fabrics, there is a special Barhampuri Pato from Ganjam, Jajpur Tassar. There are so many varieties. We have 9 products registered under the GI tag in the handloom sector. And last year in 2019, we filed a trademark and successfully obtained a trademark for Dempy Silk. So these are different product ranges that are available. And one of the marketing strategies that you and your team would know is to diversify the product range. So I think we need to focus on making consumers aware about the wide variety that is available so that sales get boosted. So expanding the market pie through all these different strategies of product diversification, awareness, new designs, and educating the weavers and making them tech savvy, I think should be our strategy and our focus. But tell me, what do you think that the Flipkart Samarth program can bring in terms of tangible benefits to the weaver community?
My sense is that one is about the incentive that you give. The incentive is about, you know, maybe commission is lower, better services on ground for sellers. But I think what they value more is about insights, and what they value more about when they start seeing that impact which e-commerce or any new model brings to them. And I think the ability to handhold and support them, I think it's less financial, more making that, enabling and empowering them. I think that's what becomes more important. I was talking to the team and they gave me an example of someone from the community of weavers. The name is Chitrangan Pal. Completely offline before. Today, you know, Chitrangan has put almost like 200 different listings on the platform. And I think the visibility that the seller is enjoying today is pretty phenomenal. That's really from my side. You know, I think, you know, if there is any closing note from your side in terms of what all we can do more. And obviously you have responded to that. But we still want to hear from you in terms of very measurable item. What is that next year hold for us? What is that end outcome that we wish to see and co-create it? And I think understanding from you, that nudge from you would be very helpful.
So you have mentioned technology, and I think in this sector I would see the technology component in 2 parts. One is in the creation of the product, where obviously you have a very limited role and the state government is proactively upgrading their tools, upgrading their looms, introducing computer-aided designing facilities and training the weavers in how they can become more efficient and their productivity can increase. But where we would really look for a blossoming partnership with Flipkart is on the marketing side, reaching the consumer. And exactly what you said, the insights on what the market is wanting and seasonal insights and color insights, because I mean this is a whole world there which predicts which colors will be in fashion in that year. And not only looking at individual consumers, though I mean the sky is the limit here, so you can target individual consumers, but I would also look at targeting big buying houses. Why not? And people have a grievance against handlooms when they say that you can't get the same product again. So there are ways of reducing that. For instance, we have introduced a quality dyeing manual in the government of Odisha last year, and we have shared it with some of our most progressive weavers in the first phase and now with all weavers, which tells you the exact proportion in which you mix certain colors to get certain shades. So supposing a buyer is asking for a deep black. Now black can have many shades, but which black does the buyer want? And if the weaver knows that, okay, if I add 2:3 of something and I get this shade, it's fairly easy for him to keep replicating that when he has a book and when he has it down in black and white in front of him. So these are small innovations, but we would also like to target the big buyers, not only in India, but also in other countries around the world, where there is a premium on handwoven, where there is a premium on these luxury goods, on these beautifully crafted textiles, and where people are willing to pay for it. So beyond a point, the Indian market is going to get saturated. And I think that is where Flipkart and e-commerce platforms will have a major role to play, because you will have a global reach, either on your own platform or through partnerships. We have 40,000 families in Orissa who are dependent on weaving as a source of livelihood. We have more than 1.25 lakh weavers with us. I would like each one of them to have this choice and this power to sell at a price of their asking, at a time of their asking, and at a place of their asking. And this is my vision or my dream or my goal for this sector, where I think I would need you as a very important part.
We will work on almost each of the aspects that we talked about, but we will obviously, continue to have your feedback, your support as we sort of navigate and deepen our presence in the state to serve the communities, and also continue to have your feedback so that we can continue to improve. Really appreciate your time and the energy that you bring to conversation.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.